Hello folks and welcome to another replay cast of a Clan Wars game. As you just saw, I'm not in the game. I'm not playing, but I got it from a teammate from me, from General Olsen, who's playing the Yu Yang. It's between Warrior Pay to Win and TWA, so Typhoon League Group 1 batch. And it shows a lot about DD play, how to DD play, and also will point out some other stuff that is maybe important. We are on the map Sea of Fortune. As we saw the lineups, we have a triple Hindenburg, two Des Moines, one Yu Yang on the enemy side, and one Montana. Our side is a bit more versatile with one Des Moines, two Hindenburgs, one Zhao, and one Moskva. So, as we also see, General Olsen is running radar on his Yu Yang. You can get the radar instead of the smoke. I don't see the point so much for myself, but when I watched the replay first, I thought, yeah, okay. Just a gimmick, but not so useful. But on the other hand, smoke isn't that useful either. So, I mean, you can make strong combos with a DD and a Zhao, and if the DD smokes up the Zhao can deal so much damage unless an enemy DD is really close to spot him or a radar. But yeah, he decided for okay, let's go for a radar. And yeah, what he told me was that he's quite satisfied and successful with it. So first of all, he's going to spot the caps. He's definitely not going to contest the cap in the early game. He wants to know where are the radar cruisers, where he has to pay attention, where's the enemy DD, and so on and so on. So first of all, on this map you don't go for capping, because it's just suicide, more or less. They have two Des Moines, probably near any of A and B cap, and near C cap. At least that's what I'm expecting when I'm playing in Group 1 of Typhoon League battles. So TWA is pretty successful. They abandon a bit their like totally pushing lineup and put in a DD again, as I saw. So yeah, they changed the meta changed a bit again. Always fun. I think it's the third time that it changed during the whole season. One thing I didn't get is why they sent the Moskva up here, because Moskva has a really strong radar, and if you want to go wide and like shoot from there, you can easily use a Hindenburg. You don't need a Moskva for it, because Hindenburg DPM and range outguns the Moskva heavily. So Moskva is mostly used to lock down caps from a bigger distance. But yeah. Okay, he throws some preemptive torps. Maybe the Des Moines is stationary, going to be stationary in that corner, so maybe he can hit some torps. That was the intention of the torps. Alright, so he's turning back, since he knows, okay, there's one radar cruiser, can't contest C. There's the enemy Yu Yang torps. Normally that would be in these kind of classic random torps that would have killed him there, but yeah, since there are these deep water torps, there is no issue, they just pass him. So the wargame paid to win Des Moines is close to A and B and covers that area. I think the enemy Des Moines is in this area here, down here. No other place would make sense in my opinion. So here I think there is an order to the Hindenburg and Zhao. Go and spot aggressively, especially with a Zhao. You can do that in a 1DD setup on the enemy team. He can outspot every other cruiser, so that's a possibility to go close and check out what's going on down there. I think they will utilize this, and yeah, we will see what comes out of there. Also, it looks like Olsen is going to make an attempt to cap A. And since he's also watching C all the time, he's like probably expecting the enemy Yu Yang to be around there, even though his RPF is showing some other things, some closer targets to some other area. Again, this the same area, topping for another angle. What makes totally sense, and also he doesn't throw the torps at once. He just delays them. So if there is a damage con and then the next volley comes in, it causes a flooding, especially on a cruiser. So that's the purpose behind this one, this action. All right, and now really important, what you want to do in a DD. If you're like contesting caps in competitive, because DDs are squishy, they don't have much hit points, they need to conserve the hit points as long as they can, because they are one of the most valuable ships, especially without carriers. So he's going with the aft first into the cap, so he can just move out there really fast if he's going to be under fire. I mean, of course, you can eat this unlucky battleship AP pens that costs you like 10k, or even we had it with a one-shot deletion already on the gearing, I can remember, so all can happen, but yeah, you want to play it as safe as you can. So now he's going into the cap, and he's probably expecting a radar to be popped soon. I, for myself, I would have like used the speed boost, because then you can just maneuver a bit quicker. So there's the radar. He waits for shots. So the Montana is shooting. Okay. Okay. Now he's moving. And the Montana itself wouldn't be the big issue, but there's a Des Moines that is also shooting, and or Hindenburg in this case. Okay. Radar. He's out of radar range. Means the Des Moines is a bit below that area, like maybe next to these islands. So, but he's fine now. And he's going for the next attempt. Meanwhile, TWA is contesting C. And there's still the radar again. Oops. okay, now it's over. Now it's over. So they made sure that they can cover the whole cap here. He's just as far away that he can cover the whole AB area. There are some blind shots, and what Olsen is doing is pretty smart, in my opinion. He's moving more into the cap. That's maybe a thing the enemy won't anticipate. Also, he's radaring. So he was expecting the Yu Yang, I guess, to come over here. So now he's going for both caps, which is pretty smart. The radar is off, so they have only the radar here, so they can't radar here again. Okay, he kept A, that's pretty good. And also note that we saw the enemy Yu Yang having smoke, because there was a smoke trail down here earlier. So he knows that he does not have any radar. But he doesn't want to risk anything, because they have like one, two ships down here, so he's leaving before he gets spotted. So that's also recommended to do in this case. Because if you look how many firepower we are having here that can support him, that's not so much, that's only the Montana at all. And they have a probably Des Moines can shoot this area, the Hindenburg, the Montana, and then on top the Yu Yang as well. So he would be pretty much alone. So he went out of there. And kind of this Yu Yang is trying strange stuff. I think he should know that he has radar now. And That's kind of a bold move he's trying out here. The enemy Yu Yang. Meanwhile, the enemy Des Moines is getting under heavy attack. And that's an issue for him. Good for Wang Yinpei to win, because then there's one less threat for him to contest this AB area. Also, our Des Moines is blocking the A cap. So Yu Yang, the enemy Yu Yang needs to go into B to cap at least something. Okay, the enemy Des Moines goes down. So that's a significant lead already. And now Olsen is doing exactly the same, going backwards in. Tries to spot the Yu Yang. Radars him. And here I would have used speed boost again, because you can like move forward, backward really, really fast. Especially to avoid these battleship shells. But yeah, I'm not the main DD player, Olsen is a main DD player, so I assume he knows what he's doing. Okay, yeah, meanwhile our A flank, or this side of the map, got strengthened. Just because they took out one Des Moines, means they have only two Hindenburgs versus Zhao, Hindenburg and Des Moines. Montana can also go in and have a fight. Yu Yang didn't run. That's interesting. Yeah, well, that smoke won't help him, I guess, because of radar. Yeah, exactly. Because this Des Moines has radar range on him. And he can't spot him. Nobody is spotting Olsen here right now, because he is out of the firing range. Okay, now he's slowly moving in and attempting to cap B. Which should be easy now. Unless the enemy Des Moines shifted over to here, then these guys have free reign, can push down here and yeah, can wrap up things. But yeah, our rest just finished off, or our A flank finished off the Hindenburg, so it means even less threats here. Montana is moving to C, since this is the strongest side. Makes total sense, because why would he be at A as well? Because there's only one ship he can shoot at. So he's going to enforce the seaside. To help out these guys there. They still stay a bit too far back right now. I think they could go closer to support the Montana. And Montana is a bit isolated there. So if there is a focus fire coming from these ships, the Montana is in big trouble. Excuse me. He's now covered, but still, that can make a difference from time to time. So enemy Montana is reversing. Okay, yeah, just throw some preemptive torps. It's not likely that you hit anything in your torps, in your DD. Oh, and that means the enemy DD is in the A area, probably in the southern part of it. So like. Here, I would say, and this oh, and also B, so he's pretty near. I don't know if I like this move, because it's of course really aggressive, but he has no backup, and of course TWA needs to risk something. But yeah, that looks more like a suicide commando right now. I mean, if the Montana would have gone in with him. Or at least in the vicinity, that would have been a thing. I don't know why Olsen is so hesitant here. You can just easily outgun him. Or he's just waiting, I guess. Yeah, that's no easy prey for him. And there he's gone. Both caps secured. Yeah, no. This game is... Unless Wang Yinpei to win is going to throw it. An easy win for Walking Pay to win, in my opinion. Of course, I watched the replay before. I'm not just clicking on it and didn't see the result. But yeah, as we all know, in the in the past, we were able to throw games. So that can actually happen. These tops were just on RPF, but the replay was misshowing it. I don't know. It is not going into the island, it's going into this gap. Des Moines is fighting the Montana that is attempting to go AB. And he should have done it a bit earlier. Or TWA is realizing, okay, we need to do something. So let's push and wreck at least some ships. We have a chance. Yeah, Des Moines shouldn't be the first line of defense there, because he's the one who's most vulnerable to AP battleship shells. And he's getting focused from everywhere. So at that point, that Hindenburg is in a good position. That Moskva needs to push down here, really aggressive, especially the Montana as well going into sea. So that has to be done simultaneously. These guys take on the Hindenburg, so everybody is occupied, and there can't be a concentrated fire on one ship. As we right see, the Moin was shot by the enemy Des Moines here, but that's the only one that can shoot him. But this is just because the enemy Des Moines is not occupied with shooting this one or that ship. So if you want to do it a bit more perfect, then the Moskva should be like pushing already. Ah, okay, the Des Moines switched. Ah, okay. Makes him, of course, vulnerable. But yeah, Montana is down now as well, and this would say, and the enemy Hindenburg as well, so this is a clear victory right now. There's nothing TWA can do about it. Yeah, it's just like farming damage, nothing else right now, or farming kills. Another preemptive torps, but it's hard to hit on this map at all, I have to say. I mean, I know it from randoms, but it's quite hard to hit torpedoes anywhere, unless the enemy is going into this middle area where the A and B cap are situated. Okay, next ship goes down. Montana is probably the next one to go down. Then they have one Hindenburg left, and that's it. So I hope you could see what I mean with from a DD perspective. As I said, I never played DD, so it might be interesting for you to see it and get a proper commentary about it. Just let me know in the comments if you want to see more about DD play or battleship play. I can try and reach out to people that are playing these classes, and maybe we find a suitable game. It looked also that, yeah, I don't know, TWA reacted a bit slow in the beginning, I think, but yeah, happens. We all make mistakes. Okay. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.